Instructions for the push-ups. The purpose of this test is to evaluate your upper body strength. You will be advised to get into the preparatory position. Your chest is flat on the testing surface. Your feet are 8 to 12 inches apart. Your hands are flat on the testing surface, shoulder-width apart, awaiting further instructions. You will get into the starting position in which only the feet and hands are in contact with the testing surface. The feet are 8 to 12 inches apart. The hands are slightly wider than shoulder width. The arms are extended and straight. The legs, buttocks, back, and shoulders must remain in straight alignment. To complete a push-up, bend the elbows to lower your torso. Keep bending the elbows until the elbows are flexed at a 90-degree angle. Once the elbows are flexed at a 90-degree angle, return to the starting position by straightening your elbows. You have reached a 90-degree angle when the back of your upper arm is even with your back. During the completion of push-ups, the legs, buttocks, back, and shoulders must remain in straight alignment. Once you reach a 90-degree angle, you can return to the correct starting position. You will do as many push-ups as possible within the 2-minute time period. You will be told when 1 minute has elapsed and when there are 30 and 15 seconds remaining. You will be given only one trial. Be careful to perform the push-ups in the proper manner. A push-up will not count if you do not lower to a 90-degree angle at the elbows. If your knees come in contact with the test surface. If your legs, buttocks, back, and shoulders do not remain in straight alignment. Or if you do not return to the starting position with your arms fully extended. If you perform an incorrect push-up, a test administrator will provide a short command to inform you of the committed error. You may rest in between push-ups during the 2-minute time period, but the stopwatch will not be stopped. You may rest on your hands and knees. If you rest, you must resume your push-ups from the proper starting position. Instructions for the sit-ups. The purpose of this test is to evaluate your trunk strength. You will lie down on your back with your knees flexed to a 45 to 60 degree angle. Your feet are flat on the floor. Your heels are placed about 12 to 18 inches from your buttocks. A second person will help by holding your feet in place during the exercise. You will put both hands behind your head and interlock your fingers. Your hands must remain behind your head with fingers interlocked at all times as you perform the sit-ups. Your chin should remain tucked towards your chest. With each sit-up, you should curl your shoulders and torso, keeping your lower back on the ground until you have curled the upper torso and come into position which your elbows touch your thigh. Make sure you curl your torso. To complete each sit-up, lie back down until your mid-back touches the test surface. You will do as many sit-ups as possible within the 2-minute time period. You will be told when 1 minute has elapsed and when there is 30 and 15 seconds remaining. You will be given only one trial. Be careful to perform the sit-ups in the proper manner. A sit-up will not count if your hands are not behind your head with your fingers interlocked. If your elbows do not touch your thighs, if your mid-back does not touch the test surface as you lie back down, and if your buttocks does not remain in contact with the test surface. If you perform an incorrect sit-up, a test administrator will provide a short command to inform you of the committed error. You may rest between sit-ups during the 2-minute time period, but the stopwatch will not be stopped. Instructions for the 1.5 mile run. The purpose of this test is to evaluate your cardiovascular endurance. All candidates in a group will take this test at the same time. You will stand on the start-finish line. On the command, go, you will begin running. You will run straight along the road until you reach the halfway mark. An administrator will be present to show you the halfway mark. Turn around at the halfway mark and run back to the start-finish line. Continue running until you cross the finish line. Your score is the total time to complete the 1.5 mile run, so attempt to complete the run as quickly as you can. If you cannot complete the run, it will be recorded as did not finish, DNF, and you will fail the test battery. You may walk or stop during the run, but the timer will not be stopped. The command will be ready, go.